today. I'm going to do the Jackal Ripper and Wright Chapel walk. When you leave Aldgate Station here, you turn to your right and you're heading towards St. Botolph Church. So we turn right here. I'm beside St. Botolph's Church, and as I said, we just cross over the traffic lights here and cross over to the other side. That's where I've just come from, St. Botolph's Church, and so we just cross over the lights. All we're going to do is carry on, and then we're going to turn left by those hoardings there. We turn left here into St. James's Passage, which takes us into Mitre Square, the scene of one of the murders. In Mitre Square, by the benches and a bit of grass, is the scene where Catherine Eddowes was murdered on the 30th of September 1888. Catherine Eddowes was the fifth victim of the Ripper. Now from here, we just carry on through and we're heading towards the Houndsditch. At the end of Mitre Street, we're going to turn to our right. I've just turned right there from Mitre Street, and here I am on Creechurch Street. And all we do is just carry on straight, and then we're going to turn left into Beavis Mark Street, and we're heading towards the Houndsditch. Okay, when you reach Beavis Mark Street here, all we do is turn to our left, cross over, and then we're going to turn right into Gorwin Street, which will take us into the Houndsditch. So we're just going straight in front, cross over, and turn to our right into Gorwin Street. Okay, when you reach this point, we're going to turn right into Gorwin Street, which takes us into Houndsditch. Okay, we're on the Houndsditch here, and the building in front, going back to 1910, was a jeweller's shop, that's where Cotter is. It was the scene of a box robbery. I'll tell you more when we get right. At the end of Gorwin Street, we're going to cross over and turn down there by my right into Cutler Street. Right here, I'm beside Cutler Street, and what we do, we go forward and we're going to turn to our right in a second into Clawfield Street. As I said, we turn right here into Clawfield Street, or it used to be called Exchange Buildings. Going back to December 1910, this was the scene of a botched jewellery robbery. Three police officers were killed, two were seriously wounded. This was the beginning of the Sydney Street Siege. From here we just carry on forward, and then we're going to turn right and then left into Harrow Place. Okay, from here we turn right and then immediate left straight up Harrow Place, which is in front. As I said, we just carry on straight up here. At the top of Harrow Place, we'll be crossing Middlesex Street, better known as Petticoat Market. In the Ripper's time, this was known as the Recycling Street, where all stolen goods, etc. were stolen. Anyway, all we do now is just continue straight in front. Okay, as I said, what we do is just carry on into Cobb Street, straight in front. I'm still on Cobb Street, and all we do is continue straight in front till we get to Bell Lane, which is in front there. I'm here now in Bell Lane, notorious for one person, Ike Solomon, who was a notorious fence in the 1820s, 30s. Anyway, what we're going to do, we're going to turn right here, cross over Wentworth Street and into Goulston Street. This is Wentworth Street, and as I said, all we're going to do is carry on straight into Goulston Street. Alright, the building I'm looking at in front is the Wentworth model dwelling, and this is the scene where a blood-stained apron belonging to Catherine Eddowes was discovered. The blood-stained apron was found there by Happy Days, with a message above it in chalk. We carry along straight along Goulston Street till we come up by Wright Chapel again, so we just continue straight. We'll be passing Middlesex University. View from Goulston Street, I'm looking back from where we've just come from. Okay, at the end of Goulston Street, all we do now is turn left, and we're heading along Wright Chapel Road. As I said, we just turn left and just carry on straight. Over there is Aldgate Underground Station where we left. And all we do know, as I said, we just carry on safe. We're going to be passing Aldgate East in a minute. As I said, we'll be passing Aldgate East Station here, and we just carry on straight, crossing Commercial Street, heading into Whitechapel Road. No, Aldgate Station is in the City of London, and Aldgate East isn't. Anyway, we just carry on. Carry along Whitechapel here, and we'll be turning up beside the White Hart Public Coast. But before that, we're going to go to the Whitechapel Gallery, which is a bit beyond the White Hart. Okay, we've got the White Hart Public Coast here, famous for, well, the person who used to have a barbershop here, George Chapman. So I'm back beside the White Hart, and what we're going to do is go through the alleyway here, Gunthorpe Street, and we're coming to the scene of the first victim, or murder of Jack the Ripper, Martha Tabram. So we just carry on straight. Just carry on near to the end. Suddenly, house in front is the scene where Martha Tabram was murdered by Jack the Ripper on the 7th of August, 1888. Now, originally, this turning, Gunthorpe Street, was called George Yard, and the building was called George Building. Anyway, from here, we're going to turn to our left and then right, and we're going into the Flower and Dean district, or the Rookery, where most of the prostitutes lived. I'm at the top of Gunthorpe Street here on Wentworth Street now. And all we're going to do is cross over the Zebras and go through the modern housing estate, which used to be the Rookeries, where all the prostitutes lived. Just go through here. All the original buildings have been knocked down. So going back in Riverstown, all this used to be old lodging houses or doss houses where the girls or prostitutes used to live. Used to pay 4p a night or whatever like this. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to turn left here and we're going to come out by Commercial Street. Of the murder victims lived down here at the time. This is all that remains of old earth clothes. To my right is Fashion Street, where two of the victims of the Ripper lived. If you continue all the way along Fashion Street here, you come out by Brick Lane. Some of the murals on Fashion Street. Okay, from Fashion Street, I'm going to cross over by the lights here, and we're going to go down White Row on a detour of some of the side turnings of Whitechapel. Now, before I cross over the traffic lights here, beside the car park there, that private road there, or whatever, used to be Dorset Street, and that's where the sixth victim, the most horrific murder, took place, along there in Mills Court. Now, as I said, on the 9th of November, 88, Mae Kelly was brutally murdered in Mills Court. It was, well, very horrific. Anyway, as I said, we're going to cut off the lights there, we're going to go down White Row, I'm going to show you some of the unseen gems of Whitechapel. Okay, I've just come up from the traffic lights. We've got Fashion Street straight in front there. We've just come up from the traffic lights, and all I'm going to do, that's Tonby Street, all we're going to do is turn right here into White Row, and I'm going to show you some of the hidden gems of Whitechapel. Okay, I've come over from Fashion Street over there, cross over the light, and I'm in White Row. It does give you a little view of where we are. That's Christ Church. And all we do now is just continue along here, and I'll just show you a few secrets of Whitechapel. At the end of White Row, we just cross over Bell Lane, which we've been on before, and just continue straight in front. Just continue straight along into the passageway there. Just continue straight. We just continue straight. We're going to be coming out by Bishopsgate. Just carry on till we get to Bishopsgate, and we'll be in front of Liverpool Street Station. Bridegate Street, we join up with Middlesex Street, which is here on my left. But as I said, we come out by Bishop's Gate and Liverpool Street Station, where we're going to turn right and we're going to turn up by Brushfield Street back into. To get to Liverpool Street Station, all you do is cross over the light and it's over there on your way. What we're going to do is turn right here and then we're going to turn right up Brushfield Street back into Spitfield. Just go along straight until we get to Brushfield Street and then we're going to turn right into it. As I said, we turn right here into Brushfield Street and we'll be coming beside Spitfield Market and Christchurch. So we just carry on straight. Carry on the street. Okay, when you get to the Pear Sculpture, we'll turn right and then left into Spitalfields Market. Okay, we're just going to Spitalfields for a moment. Okay, what we're going to do is just carry on straight and we leave by that entrance, coming over onto Commercial Street again. I've just left Spitalfields Market and I'm looking across at the Ten Bells Pub. But the Ten Bells famous for one thing, but all the victims of the Ripper drank there. It was a local meeting point for all the working girls. What I'm going to do, I'm going to cross over the lights here. I'm going to go along Fourier Street, which is between Christchurch there and the Ten Bells. So basically we cross the lights and just go straight. I'm on Fourier Street now, just past the Ten Bells public house. Beside me is Christchurch. And what we're going to do is take the first turn in on the left. Okay, we're going to turn left, turn to Wilkes Street, heading on towards Hanbury Street, where the third murder took place. Carry along Wilkes Street, passing Puma Court, until we get to the end. I'm still on Wilkes Street. This is a turning off Wilkes Street. Just give you a view. Now at the end of Wilkes Street we're at the Truman's Brewery, Old Brewery. Now what it is, it's an enterprise zone for small business, artists, etc. Well worth a visit. You'll be here all day. Anyway, we're on Hanbury Street here. We're going to turn right and we're coming to the third victim. As I said, we're going to turn right here into Hanbury Street. And the third victim of the Ripper was Annie Chapman. I'm standing outside 30 Hanbury Street. And in front was 29 Hanbury Street, where Annie Chapman was murdered by the Ripper on the 8th of September 88, the most brutal murder, the third victim. Okay, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to carry on all the way along Hanbury Street till I get to Valence Street. Okay, here is the famous Brick Lane. And all we do, we just carry on, cross over Brick Lane, carry along Hanbury Street. Just carry on straight along Hanbury Street. I'm still on Hanbury Street and we just carry on straight. Okay, I've just left all the shops etc. and all we do is continue straight till we come to Valence Street. So we just carry along Hanbury. Just continue straight in front. At the end of Hanbury Street we come to Valence Street and all we do is cross over here, carry on and then we're going to cross over and turn left into Durwood Street to victim number. Okay, we're beside Valence Street, we've just come off at Hanbury Street. So we turn down here and we're going to cross over and then left into Durwood Street where victim number 2, Polly Nichols, was killed. Okay, the main road in front is Whitechapel Road. But as I said, we're going to cross here and we're going to turn up Durwood Street where Polly Nichols was murdered. Just carry on straight in front. Okay, I'm on Durwood Street here, And this is where Polly Nichols on the 31st of August 1888 met her end by the Ripper. It's all changed here now, but this is the site. And she's murdered in front of the stables, rather gruesomely. Anyway, we're just going to carry on straight, and then we're going to turn round to our right into Brady Street, back onto Whitechapel Road. As I said, we turn right here into Brady Street, and we're going to end up on Whitechapel Street Road. At the end of Brady Street, I'm back on Whitechapel Road, and what I'm going to do is a slight detour. I'm going to turn to my left beside the Blind Beggar pub, George Cornell at Point Blank Range. I got the Blind Beggar behind me, and in front, across the light, you got Sydney Street. Now, in 1911, 3rd of Jan, the end of Sydney Street Siege, or the Sydney Street Siege, took place. It's no longer there, the house, it's been knocked down. The building standing there now is Wexford House, but at the time it was 100 Sydney Street, and that is where the Sydney Street Siege ended. It all started at the homestead at that jeweller's shop. Okay, from the Blind Beggar, I'm heading back, turn to my right, heading along Whitechapel, I'm heading towards the Bell Foundry now. Whitechapel Underground Station, which is facing the London Hospital. Across the road is the Royal London Hospital, famous for the Elephant Man, John Merrick. That is the main entrance in there. Anyway, we just carry along Whitechapel Road till we get to the Bell Foundry. Okay, when you get to this point, what we're going to do is cross over the traffic lights here and turn to our right and carry on till we get to the Bell Foundry. I've just passed the London Muslim Centre, and in front is the Bell Foundry, Whitechapel Bell Foundry, on Plumbers Road. So we're going to turn left here into Plumbers Road beside the Bell Factory. I'm outside the Bell Foundry. And as I said, we just turn up here, heading into Plumbers Road. What we're going to do is just carry on straight in front. We're heading towards the fourth victim of the Ripper. Just carry on straight, we've just passed the Tesco. We're heading towards Elizabeth Stride, the fourth victim of the Ripper. At the end of Plumbers Row, we're going to turn left, then right into Greenfields. Alright, Greenfield Street here, we turn right, which takes us onto Commercial Road, where we're going to cross and head down Henriquez Street. Okay, we're on Commercial Road, but what we do is go up to the lights there, cross over, and then we're going to go straight down that street there, Henriquez Street. Okay, I've just crossed over the lights there, and as I said, we're going to turn down here, Henriquez Street. In the Ripper's day, it was called Berner Street, and this is where the fourth murder took place, Elizabeth Stride. Okay, I'm outside Bernard Baron House, and opposite this place, this building, was the murder of Elizabeth Stride in Dutsfield Yard. It's no longer with us, but where the gates are is where she was murdered. He only strangled her and cut her throat. He wasn't able to mutilate her, it seems he was disturbed. And on the same night, the 30th of September 1888, he went up to Mitre Square and killed Catherine Eddowes, the second victim. Anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to head towards Cable Street, hopefully, where the Battle of Cable Street took place, and then head back to Aldgate, where the walk ends. Anyway, we just carry on straight in front, and then we're going to bear to our left. Okay, we just turn left here into Fairclough Street, the first turn in on the left, and then we're going to turn. At the end of Fairclough Street, all we do is turn right into Christian Street and carry on straight until we come to Cable Street. Just continue straight. Continue straight in front under the bridge, and then we're going to bear to our right into Cable Street. So we just continue straight. But here we are on Cable Street. And what we're going to do, as I said, we turn to our right and we're heading for the junction between Leimar Street, Royal Mint Street and Dock Street, where the Battle of Cable Street took place. Okay, on the 4th of October 1936, a Sunday, this is where the Battle of Cable Street took place. Behind me were the residents of the East End. In front was the police and beyond was the fascists. And the East End stood ground here to keep the fascists out and the poor police were stuck in the middle. Anyway, from here we're going to turn right into Leimar Street and take the first left into Chambers Street. So we turn right here. As I said, we're going to take the first left here into Chambers Street. Just continue along here and then we're going to turn right into Magdalen Passage. Okay, when you get to this point, we turn right here into Magdalen Passage. Oh, at the end of Magdalen Passage, all we do is cross over Prescott Street, straight on to Mark Street. In front is the Travel Lodge Hotel, Anyway, we just carry on. In 1737, this area on Mark Street was known as Goodman's Fields. And there was a gun battle taking place here between Dick Turpin and his mate Robert King and the law. Robert King was fatally wounded here. Dick Turpin hung 2 years later. Anyway, we just continue straight. Just continue straight ahead. Oh, at the end of St. Mark's Street, all we do is turn to our left into Ailey Street and we're going to cross Mansell Street into Little Southampton, Somerset Street. I've just turned around here to my left into Ailey Street from St. Mark's, so we just carry on to the end and we're going to cross over Mansell Street into Little Somerset. As I said, all we do is cross Mansell Street here and turn up Little Somerset Street, which is in front there. As I said, we turn up here Little Somerset Street and it takes us all the way back to Aldgate Station where the walk starts. Just continue round till we come up beside Aldgate. In front is Aldgate Station where we started the Jack the Ripper and Whitechapel walk. I hope you enjoyed the walk. This dragon in front symbolises the boundary of the City of London. And in front you got Aldgate.